I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at another one of DaVinci Resolve 12's new features, and this is the ability to optimize clips that you've imported into your project. Optimizing clips is very straightforward. So what I've done is I've created a smart bin. This is another one of DaVinci Resolve 12's new features. And this smart bin, if I double click it to edit it, is using the media pool properties group of metadata. I can use all kinds of criteria. For example, if I go down to codec, I can use the codec. If the codec contains DNG, there are all of my Cinema DNG clips. Now, if I want, I can select these clips, right-click, and choose Generate Optimized Media. And if I do so, I'm going to do so with this one clip right here. I get a dialog with a progress bar that lets me know how long that's going to take. This happens to be a really long clip. So I can go have a coffee before coming back and being ready to go. I'm going to cancel this, because if I ever have any question about which clips have been optimized and which clips haven't, I can put the media pool into list view. And in list view, there's a new column, optimized media. If it's not shown, you can show it by right-clicking in the headers of the column and choosing optimized media. And you'll see that the optimized media column is showing me which clips have optimized media, and also what resolution the optimized media is in. And this brings me to a good point. If I open up the project settings and go down to general options, there's a new section here for optimized media. And I have two choices I can make. Choice number one is what format I want the optimized media to be in. And you have a selection of high quality to low quality formats. I've got all the ProRes codecs. I've got all the new DNX HR codecs from Avid. And up at the top, I've got uncompressed formats. These are proprietary Blackmagic formats up here if I need the absolute best quality optimized media. In addition, I have the ability to choose what resolution I want the optimized media to be in. Choose automatically basically tries to use whatever ratio of shrinkage is required to make my clips match as closely as possible the current resolution of the timeline. That's why these optimized clips are all showing half res. They were 4K clips, and at half res, they're matching the 1080 resolution of my timeline nicely. So I'm going to cancel out of this. Once I've optimized my media, it's a very easy thing for me to use it. It just works like any other clip. If I go up into the playback menu, there's a command, used optimized media if available. When this is checked, I'm using optimized media. So if I open up a clip in the source viewer, I'm now using the optimized media rather than the raw media. And if I jump into the color page, same thing. I'm just invisibly behind the scenes using the optimized media. So if, for example, I were to go into the motion effects palette and add a little bit of noise reduction just to stress my computer out, you can see that right now I'm maintaining about 20 or so frames per second of performance. And again, this is my 27-inch iMac. If I go back up to playback and turn off use optimized media if available, I've now behind the scenes gone back to using the raw clip, and now I'm only getting about 13 frames per second of performance because now I'm noise reducing a much bigger resolution piece of media. So that's how to use optimized media in a nutshell. There's more detail about this function and all the other new features in DaVinci Resolve 12 in my new title for Ripple Training, New Features in DaVinci Resolve 12. Thanks a lot for listening.